7 years back on urban area drinking water augmentation, that project was. So I thought of taking a Belgaum area because that was hardly drinking water, similar to this Bangalore. So I approached the municipality, and fortunately the commissioner and the water supply engineers were very good, very forthcoming, and they encouraged me that we go and have a survey of the wells and come back to us, we will think of doing something. So then I went around the city and found that many open wells are there which are not used.
Private
open wells. Even some are public, some are public wells. Many of them are public and very high yielding wells. I found them, they are not being used at all. And very high yielding. I tell you one example in near railway station, water column was 27 meters in a well. 27 meter water column. Huge amount of water potential was there. Then I reported back to these people and we sat together, we worked out, and commissioner was very happy to sanction crores of rupees for installing the filter point on those points. First we cleared those wells, and those, some of the wells could not be cleared because the yield was so high that we could not clean them all. Very high yielding wells. So then they fixed each of those wells, they fixed the filter points on the site itself, and they augmented the municipal water supply with these four wells. And then each carburetor was behind us. Please come to our ward also and then see the wells, whether they can be done. So we could do, I think, at least 15 wells at that time. Then they, again, they did on themselves. So this was a very good project we did during those time to augment the city water supply. And the wells were revived. Otherwise, some wells were being used as a dumping ground there. People used to throw rubber and other things. Then they stopped. And the awareness was brought to those people, and water was supplied 24 hours.
Common feature for any urban centers in India, that wherever they are getting water supply from surface water sources, so their rejects are going to the city, and water levels are rising in the core area of the city. But the quality is the main concern, and mainly it is nitrate. Nitrate is a carcinogen, and if we use that water over long periods, then it causes an adverse effect. Whereas if it is E. coli, it is okay, just boiling will solve the problem. And the adverse effect also is, impact also immediate. It is a cholera problem if it is E. coli. Whereas if it is chemical pollution, it is the effect is will be felt after long usage. So in Bangalore also we have studied around the core area of Bangalore, water levels are rising, but that water, unless it is treated, especially our treatment, not boiling further increases the contaminants, chemical contaminants. So that cannot be used for drinking and domestic purposes. Other than domestic purposes, for all other purposes, like grey water, we can use it for flushing, washing, and all other uses.
I would
say 80s. It was mainly hand pump based. The Chennai was a lot of hand pump based before that. There's a lot of pipes, underground pipes, which came up then. And ever since, people have been using open duct wells at their homes. Yes. And there was a year when there was conflicts for pipe supply water. And actually in the main season, one found that the wells were going dry. And so this study covers all the aspects. So one important point which he says is that there is a lot of recharge happening into such large cities which have underground pipe systems. So often we find the shallow aquifers have water. But the shallow aquifers are also connected with, you know, just open latent pits and, you know, the kind of sanitation systems which are there, and also sewage, if it exists. So basically it's safe water getting into sewage, and you have a lot of it in the shallow aquifers. I'm sure, for example, cities like Mumbai, where there is almost no pumping, it's filled with water. When you construct, you find that it's filled with, because it's years of water supply. It's all, you know, and it's just flowing down the rivers.
Is there a general pattern across the country, and therefore a set of guidelines that urban areas should follow with respect to both groundwater management, recharge, you know, in terms of rainwater harvesting, do you recharge, do you store? What is the general?
Both the statements are correct, telling that it is a concrete general, and there is no natural recharge. That is what you mean. Rainwater recharge.
Yeah.
Whereas there is a detail, it is established fact that surface water supply, and at the minimum it is 20% is unaccounted water leakage. So that added to that, sewage also is entering. And our sewage system, we know very well that it is not that foodproof.
Yeah.
So part of the sewage water is entering into the aquifer, and this is chemical pollution. More than the E. coli and all, we are much worried about chemical pollution, mainly nitrate. And added to it, one more factor is that our solid waste dumping. So Bangalore, you see any open area, any open site, that is a dumping site. And that leaches further into the ground. And that's why it is a point source. So nitrate is very tricky, unlike fluoride. Fluoride, it is geogenic, we know. One area is mapped, means surrounding area will be there. Whereas nitrate, each well has to be, before using, each well has to be tested and certified. Otherwise, your well will be there, neighboring well will be safe. So nitrate, it is very tricky. And it is carcinogen established, because nitrosamine, it is creates in our digestive acid. When it interacts with the acid, it causes nitrosamine. And blue velvet syndrome, it is only for infants. If this water is used for making the milk product, then this hemoglobin is converted to methemoglobin, and that doesn't have the quality to oxygen exchange in our lungs, in the infant's lungs. That's why infant dies for lack of oxygen.